What's going on? I'm Anton and I'm back with another vlog where today I will be taking you behind the scenes right here in my studio and I'll be giving you an in-depth look at my studio lighting and how I set it all up. So roll the intro. I get a lot of questions about my lights, so let's start with the ones that I use here the most, called the Philips Hue lights, like this guy right here. This is the Philips Hue Go. It's a little bowl-shaped light, which you can see over my shoulder during my live streams and my videos. It retails for about $80 US on Amazon, and this light has a battery, which is great if you want to move it around, or even take it somewhere with you, like to your backyard, for example. I also like it because it's got this unique shape to it, and unlike a bulb, it doesn't require a light fixture like a lamp in order for it to work. I actually have a few of these around the house, like on my nightstand, to provide some cool ambient lighting. Along with the Hue Go over my shoulder, I also have other Philips lights, which I use to light up the bookcase behind me. One of them is the Hue Bloom, which acts like a spotlight and just sits on one of the shelves. It's an older Philips Hue light, and you can pick this one a little bit cheaper than the Hue Go over at Amazon. It's about $60 US. But unlike the Hue Go, this one is always angled, and it doesn't have a battery, which means it's just not as versatile as the Hue Go. The rest of the bookcase is lit up by the Light Strips Plus, which run along both sides. These are really cool for lighting up furniture because they're essentially long LED strips with sticky tape on the underside to allow for mounting. I use three strips here in the studio, two of which are in the bookcase, and the other one wraps the back of the console off to the side. These are a little bit more expensive than the other lights at around $90 US per strip, but you can bend, cut, or extend these to really shape where you want the light to be. And the actual LEDs are a lot better than the other two lights, which means brighter and stronger colors compared to the Go or the Bloom. And then, of course, there are the more traditional Hue bulbs. Philips has many different types of bulbs, but the one I use here in the studio are what's known as the standard A19 bulbs, meaning you can screw them into your regular light fixtures, like lamps, ceiling lights. I have four of these in total, two of them in the ceiling light, and two in the camera lights, which are just really cheap desk lamps that I bought at IKEA. And these bulbs are great because they can turn just about any color as well as neutral colors, which is great for lighting up my face during the streams and videos. They can be a little bit pricey per bulb, but you can also pick up the starter kit for about $200 on Amazon, which comes with three bulbs and a bridge. Now, this is important as you need the bridge in order to control your Hue light. This is what plugs into your router and allows you to control your lights through the app on your phone or tablet. Without the bridge, none of the Hue lights will work. So if you're just thinking of grabbing the Hue Go or the light strip, you'll have to pick up the bridge separately, which is going to run you about another $60 US. The Hue ecosystem has other components to further take control of your lights, like the motion sensors, which are sold separately. They sense when you enter the room and turn the lights on for you. So if you really want to go all in on smart lighting, the Philips Hue is a great platform to do so. I highly recommend it. They've been around for a while and have significantly refined their products over the years. Now that I've got all these lights, you're probably wondering how I make all of the light shows on my streams. Well, for that, I took an older Android tablet, which I was no longer using, and I mounted it to the side of my desk so I can use it kind of like a control console for my lights. I use an app called Hue Pro, which runs on the tablet and communicates with a Hue Bridge to send commands to the lights. Using Hue Pro, I've set up light recipes like the one you see here for my light spikes. These can get pretty complex, especially when you have a lot of lights and you're trying to sync them to music. But once you set the light recipe up, it's as easy as creating a widget and then pressing it with your finger in order to start the light show. And because all of my studio lights are Philips Hue, it really makes it easy to prep my lighting for live streams as I don't have to turn everything on one light at a time. I just hit a button on my light console and boom, all the lights turn on exactly how I specified in my light recipe. Once I'm done streaming or recording, I hit another button to turn it all off, or if it's evening time, I put the studio into night mode for some cool ambient lighting while I work on editing. So that's the Philips Hue. But I also have another light, which I use here in the studio, and that's the one that is not part of the Hue system. It's called the Nanoleaf Aurora, and this is a whole new different lighting experience, because it's not a bulb or a spotlight, it's a series of modular triangular panels which you can mount on your wall. There are connections on each side of the triangle, so you can create any shape you want, and the panels are capable of producing millions of colors, which makes for some great backdrops for videos. The Aurora can get a little bit pricey. The 9-panel starter pack is gonna run you at least $200 US, and if you want to make more elaborate designs, you can pick up the 3-panel expansion packs for about $60 each. So this is definitely more of a premium lighting solution, but it does make for some really amazing light shows, as not only can it produce all sorts of colors, but many different patterns as well. I use the Aurora as the backdrop for my vlogs and promo videos, but you don't really see it on my live streams because first, it's mounted behind my camera, but also because since it's not part of the Hue system, it would be difficult for me to control it to get it to sync up with the other Hue lights during the stream for light shows. Plus, while I'm live streaming or recording videos, the Aurora is actually on to give me a little bit of a light show as well, and that way I can enjoy some cool lights along with you. So there you have it, an in-depth behind the scenes look at how I do my lighting. Feel free to ask me questions in the comments down below, and I've included links to all of the lights in the description, so if you are thinking of picking them up for yourself, you'll easily find them right down below. Thanks for watching another vlog. Smash that like button if you love the lights, and subscribe if this is your first time watching me, so you'll be able to enjoy some really great gaming content. I'll catch you on the next one. Bye!